bitch, that just came to play, baby. Yeah.
Baby, let me tell you, you so fine, you so sexy. Baby, let me tell you, you a dime. Baby, let's be friends. I can spend this money on a time if you let me.
What is up, everybody? It's your boy, King Boys Productions, and I am back at it with another reaction video. Yo, man, this man's coming out with hella videos today. This is crazy. Yeah, it's crazy. But better believe it. Let me be honest here. If you guys are seeing this, or this one will definitely be out on Friday. But, like, let's just say, for example, if I don't get some videos done, I think I will because I think I have a lot of time tomorrow. I have one thing to do in the morning, but then I'm free pretty much most of the day until I got another thing. So, like, I'll probably have time to edit some of these, and I'm going to start editing tonight. What time is it? 12? Yeah, you see, your boy has some time. So, there's probably going to be, like, 6 videos that came out today. So, you know, hopefully you guys are fucking with the extra uploads. Because I try to, you know, usually I only have, like, 3 songs that I'm really interested in. So, that's, like, all I put out. But today there was a lot of stuff, man. There was just a lot of stuff to react to. But today, obviously, you guys can tell by the title. We're here with Lil Nas X Panini remix featuring DaBaby. And this is like a Chowder video. I think that's what the whole... I'm pretty sure Panini was like Chowder's... I watched a little Chowder. I wasn't like huge into Chowder. I thought it was funny. It was definitely a funny show. I didn't really watch a ton of it. I only really watched it when my brother would watch it. And I, you know, I thought it was funny, but I didn't really watch it that much. I watched this one in Flapjack a little bit, but... and I'm pretty sure Panini... I think he said this before, but Panini was like Chowder, who's like the main character, was like the love interest of the show, and she like loved him or whatever, and he didn't really like fuck with her kind of thing. He was like, ah, kind of back off, Panini. Her name was Panini. So that's where that comes from. But like, honestly, when I just saw this, so like, obviously this just came out. This is, I'm recording this at 12:07. It's 12:07 right now, so this came out 7 minutes ago. I'm gonna be honest, I was not expecting... Of all, like, he kind of teased it earlier. He said Panini remix later, and he posted a video. It was like, I can't remember what it was. It was like an Indian version of Panini or something like that. Like, some Indian guys were like dancing to it, and it was like an Indian version. And I, you know, obviously people took it as a joke, but then he's like, in the comments, he's like, no, seriously. And then someone, like, one of those big like rap accounts on Twitter tweeted like, new stuff dropping tonight, and one of them was Panini remix. So I was like, I don't know if that's 100% true or what, but apparently it was true. And I'm gonna be honest, when I saw that a remix to Panini was dropping, DaBaby is not someone that I would have pictured on it, to be honest. You know, I like DaBaby. I really like his music. I like, his voice is so unique and his flow is just so good, and I really fuck with a lot of stuff that he's been putting out. But I don't know if I would have expected him on this one, to be honest. I would have expected someone else, but I'm here for it. I am here for it. And I know what y'all are thinking. I'm like, shut the fuck up and listen. Yeah, okay. Let me just speak my mind. You know, DaBaby, like I said, I fuck with his music heavy. But, like, I just would not have expected him to be on this song, on this remix. But let's listen to it. I mean, I don't know if it's going to be like his Old Town Road remixes where... his verse stays the same, but then DaBaby just has like a verse in the middle or something like that. Who knows? Maybe this is Old Town Road Part 2, because this is like when the first remix of the song dropped and then it blew up. Maybe it's like that. Who knows? But anyway, let's get it. I still love this.
Hey, Panini. Don't you be a meanie, thought you wanted me to go, or why you trying to keep me teeny, it's a dreamy, wish they don't.
I wonder if they got the same people that animated Chowder to do this, or they just got like different, like random animators, because like this is, obviously he's kind of following along with the lyrics and stuff. I thought it was just going to be like clips from Chowder or whatever, but like it just actually is like following along with like what he's saying and stuff like that, so I really wonder if these are the actual Chowder animators that did this or not. Well, maybe not. Like, it looks pretty damn close on to what he looked like.
I thought you want this for my life, said you wanted to see me thrive, you lie.
What I always loved about Chowder too, was I always thought was super funny, is that the pattern on his hat never moves. Like, the pattern stays the same, but his hat, like, will move around, but the pattern, like, moves with the hat, like, doesn't...
I just
like, the pattern doesn't move, it's weird.
What you want from
me. Just say to me.
They better have schnitzel in this bit. Oh, there he is. Right as I'm saying, they better have schnitzel. Rada, 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 rada. They better have schnitzel in this bitch, and he was right there. What was Oh, he's about to come in, but what was the mom's or the grandma's name? I can't remember her name. She has like the little saggy tit mushroom hat. What was her name? I can't remember her name. She had that annoying ass voice though. I can't remember a lot of it. I know Chowder, obviously Panini, Schnitzel. I don't remember what the dude at the big ass, the like head chef. I can't remember what his name was. Big ass nose and mustache. And then his wife, that was the other girl that I was thinking of. I can't remember her name too, but I just remember Schnitzel because he's rada 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 rada.
Let's go. Okay, this song right here remind me of my ex. I be declining all her calls and I'm responding to her texts. I be like, girl, hush your mouth. You know I ain't got time for them, but she know I injured my right hand. So when I get
hey, I like how they kind of censored it though. He said I ain't got time for nothing, but it was like. That was kind of funny. I don't know why that was funny.
Got time for them, but she know I injured my right hand. So when I get behind, I use my left.
She watched
the walk of Texas run. She said, I remind her of Nas X. I'm talking nope, down road, up my own, down low. They like girls and I like girls three at a time, sometimes four. And if my back and out of hundreds and ain't no time, then I don't go. I be like,
okay, baby.
What you want from me? Just say. Don't you be a mean.
Look at this dumbass bird. I don't remember, like, I'm gonna be honest. Like I said, I don't really remember a lot of the show. Was that shit in the show? The little flying bird ass plane like that?
I thought you wanted me to go. Why you trying to keep me teeny now?
Is it supposed to be, like, kind of remixing the music video a little bit? Because, like, remember Sky Jackson was in the plane and he was following her? But she was, like, disgusted. But this is, like, the opposite and she's, like, really happy to see him?
Now they need
I don't know.
Me. Number one, I'm screaming. You know, yeah, you used to love me. So what happened? What's the meaning? I thought you want this for my life. For my life.
You got all the bands now, too?
Said you wanted to see me thrive. You lied. Now when it's all done.
Damn, he threw her ass out the plane.
And I get the upper
damn,
hand.
I need a
big bitch, not another fan. But I still want you as a fan. I'ma need a sit down. I don't mean to make demands, but I need you to say to me what you want from me. Just say to me.
This song is so good. Like, I don't care what people used to like. People can hate on this man all he wants, but this song is a hit. Like, I've heard people say like this song is like super childish or whatever, but like this man is kind of capitalizing off of the clean stuff. Like Old Town Road, that song was popping and it was clean, so like parents were cool with their kids listening to it because it was a clean song. There was not like swearing in it, and like obviously he has some songs where he does swear in them, but like a song like this, like Panini, like obviously he kind of censored out the baby's part. The baby kind of had a little sexual stuff that he said, so like maybe not the remix is like not a lot of people are gonna like let their kids maybe listen to it because he said I broke my left hand, so I used my right when I hit it from the back or something like that. It's like, okay. But, like, but yeah, it's just like, it's that's what made it. I'm going to talk about it more at the end.
What you want from me.
It said the animators on the bottom, so I don't know if those are the people that animated the show. You guys will have to let me know in the comments, because you guys always know more than me for some reason. Like, it's like people like literally do research on this shit, and I'm like, I feel dumb as hell, because like y'all be like, duh. Like, how could you not know? Like, I did the Post Malone video a couple days ago, like last week, and like I thought like there was like a guitar part in like the song with Ozzy Osbourne. I was like, oh, is that Ozzy on the guitar? And they're like, people are like, no. That is not Ozzy on the guitar. He doesn't play guitar. Yes, he does, first of all. But also, they're like, no, it's not Ozzy. I'm like, oh, sorry. Like, sorry that I didn't know. You know, people were, like, actually pissed off at me. Like, how could you say it was Ozzy? But, yeah, man. Like I was saying, man, this guy does his thing. And, like, I get that people want to call it, like, oh, that clean rap, blah, 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 the childish-style rap. But, like, when you get a song, you're not going to get a, let's be honest, you're not going to get a song to go 19 straight weeks at number one if the younger generations are not listening to it. You know, if there was like a lot of sexual things or like a lot of swearing in Old Town Road, it would not have done as good as it did. And I guarantee you that. Because it got super popular, not only because people my age, like 20s, younger teens, probably like 18 to 20s, like 18 to 25 range, everyone that from that range, people in college were fucking with the song, man. People were fucking with the song. And I know kids were fucking with the song because I heard it. I heard like the kids, like my siblings were all singing the song, all knew it word for word. And at first, you know, like I remember the first time I played it, like we had like a family party. I put the song on. They all knew it word for word. I was like, what? They all know it word for word. You know, a lot of them are on like TikTok and all that stuff. So they like know it from there and then they listen to it and stuff. But like that's how it became such a big song to me. It's because it was a clean song. They could play it on the radio fully, you know. Parents weren't like, oh my god, what are you listening to, you know? It wasn't like, oh, fuck this bitch, fuck that shit, you fuck that, blah blah blah. It wasn't like that. So parents weren't like, oh my god, even if it was the censored version, you know, like parents are still gonna be like, what the hell is this, you know? I mean I'm not gonna like censored, like obviously like younger kids, like if my kid's like old enough to be like, you know, I'm not gonna be that parent that's like, this music's gonna rot your brain, you know, that bullshit, like this music is gonna turn you into an angry kid. No, it's not. Like, shut the fuck up with that. Like, that's so stupid when people say that. But, and that's the thing about Panini, too, is that, like, it's a clean song. There's not a lot of there's no cursing in the original. There's a little bit of kind of sexual things in the remix with the baby, but I fuck with it. Like, the baby, he did a good-ass job. Like I said, he was not one of the first people that I would have expected on a remix to this, but, like, I'm here for it. So, and I also, I don't know if it's true or not, but, I think he said something about Travis Scott getting on a rodeo remix. I don't know if that's for sure happening or not, but man, this man is really thriving right now. And I like I said, I've said this before, but I like to see it. I hope this man keeps doing his thing. I really respect his game. I saw this, he had an interview with on LeBron James' show, The Barbershop. It's LeBron James and Maverick Carter. They do like this little talk show with a bunch of people. And they asked Lil Nas X, they're like, oh, why did you come out when you did? And he goes, when you come out at the top, when you're at the top, like he was still at number one at that time, people know you're not bullshitting. And he's like, if I fell off and I was down back in the dumps and I all of a sudden I'm like, oh yeah, I'm gay, people are going to think like, oh, he's just saying, oh, he's gay just to bring himself back up or put himself back in the media's attention. They're going to think he did that for the clout or for whatever. But he's like, If he came out right when he did, it's like you're already at the top, and now people are gonna know you're not bullshitting just for some clout or whatever. That you're dead serious. This is who you are, which I thought that shit was so cool when he said that, and I really thought that thing was so powerful. And of course, I kind of didn't like how they had Kevin Hart. That episode, if you guys ever watched The Barbershop, I like Kevin Hart, but he's not good on shows like that because he tries to lead conversation too much. To a point where it gets like, okay, Kevin Hart, shut the fuck up. I want to listen to what other people have to say. Like, I love Kevin Hart, and hopefully he has a speedy recovery. I know he got into that accident a few weeks ago, or like last week, and he like fucked up his back really bad, and his friend also fucked up their back. So hopefully they have a speedy recovery. But yeah, man, I just think like he wasn't really good for a show like that because he like takes over conversations, and it's just like, all right, move. I want to listen to what other people have to say. Like, I wanted to hear more from Lil Nas X. He only had that one little segment, and then he never talked again the whole rest of the show. So it was like, it was tough. But yeah, I hope to see this. If that's true, little Travis Scott on a rodeo remix, that would be fire as fuck. And then I'm excited to see what he does for the album. I hope he drops the album by the end of this year. I don't know if he will for sure. He's probably working on it right now, but I'm excited to hear the album when that comes out finally. So yeah. If you guys did like, please leave a like. Please subscribe. The original video is in the description down below if you'd like to check that out for yourself. Hey, man, give your boy a subscribe. You know, give your boy some likes. 6 likes for today. Your boy, I gave you all hella videos. Hella videos today. The least you could do is just float your boy a like, you know. I do appreciate it. What the fuck is going on out there? The least you could do is just throw your boy a like. And if you're new, hit that subscribe button. Because I like to post. I post weekly. Sometimes twice a week, depending on what stuff comes out. Most of the time, it's once a week. And if I ever don't post a week, it's just because I'm busy. You know, your boy's in school. Your boy has other shit going on, too. So I try to keep posting and stuff like that. But if I don't, it's just, it is what it is. All right, thank you guys, and until next time, it's your boy King Boys Production. Squaw. Realize your dark side collides inside.